Hello everyone and welcome to Learnaholic India. In today's session, we are going to see most frequently asked data structure interview questions and answers. Here is a list of questions that are going to be covered in today's session. We are going to see each and every question in detail. So let's start. So the first question is, what is an algorithm? An algorithm is a step-by-step method of solving a problem. It is commonly used for data processing, data calculation, and other related computer and mathematical operations. An algorithm is used to manipulate data in different manners. For example, inserting a new data item, searching for a particular item, or sorting of an item. In simple words, algorithm is a step-by-step procedure which is used to define a set of instructions that are to be executed in certain order to get the desired output. The next question is, what is data structure? A data structure is a specialized format for organizing, processing, retrieving, and storing data. While there are several basics and advanced data structure types, any data structure is designed to arrange data to suit a specific purpose so it can be accessed and worked within in appropriate ways. In the computer programming, a data structure may be selected or designed for storing data for the purpose of working on it with the various algorithms. Each data structure contains information about the data values, relationship between the data values, and the functions that can be applied to the data. Data structures are often classified by their characteristics. So let's see the characteristics one by one. First is linear or non-linear. This characteristic describes whether the data items are arranged in a chronological sequence, such as with an array, or in an unordered sequence, such as with a graph. The next is homogeneous or non-homogeneous. This characteristic describes whether all the data items in a given repository are of the same type or of the various types. The next is static or dynamic. This characteristic describes how the data structure are compiled. Static data structure have fixed sizes, structures, and memory locations at a compile time. In dynamic data structure, it has various sizes, structure, and the memory location that can shrink or expand depending upon the use. Now let's see the types of data structures. Data structure types are determined by what type of operation are required or what kind of algorithms are going to be applied. So let's see data structure. Arrays, stacks, queues, trees, graphs, trees, and hash tables. So what is an array? Array stores a collection of items at adjoint memory location. Items that are in the same type get stored together so that the position of each element can be calculated or retrieved easily. Arrays can be fixed or flexible in length. Next is stack. Stack stores a collection of items in the linear order that operations are applied. This order could be the last in, first out. Next is queue. A queue stores a collection of items similar to a stack. However, the operation order can be the first in, first out. Next is linked list. A linked list stores a collection of an items in a linear order. Each element or node in a linked list contains a data items as well as a reference or link to the next item in the list. The next is trees. A tree stores a collection of an items is an abstract or in hierarchical way. Each node is linked to other node and that can have multiple sub-values, also known as children. Next is graph. A graph stores a collection of items in a non-linear fashion. Graphs are made up of a finite set of nodes, also known as vertices, and lines that connects them, also known as edges. These are the useful for representing a real-life examples, for example, computer network. Next is tries. A try or a keyword tree is a data structure that stores string as a data item that can be organized in a visual graph. Next is hash table. A hash table or a hash map stores a collection of an item in an associative array that plots the keys to the graph. A hash table uses a hash function to convert an index into the array or bucket that contains a desired data item. Next question is, what is graph? Graphs are the mathematical structures that are used to represent the pairwise relationship between the objects. A graph is a flow structure that represents the relationship between the various objects. It can be visualized by using the two basic components. First is node and second is edges. So what is node? Nodes are the most important components in any graph. Nodes are the entities whose relationship are expressed using the edges. If a two graphs comprises two nodes A and B and an undirected edge between them, then it express a bidirectional relationship between the nodes and edges. Next is edge. Edges are the components that are used to represent the relationship between the various nodes in a graph. An edge between the two nodes expresses a one-way or two-way relationship between the nodes. The next question is, why do we use stack? The answer to this question is, in a data structure, stack is an abstract data type which is used to store or retrieve the values in the last in first out manner, that is in LIFO manner. Stacks follows the LIFO manner and addition and retrieval of the data item, which takes O of n time. Stacks are used where we need to access the data in the reverse order or their arrival. Stacks are used commonly in the recursive function call, expression parsing, depth first traverser of graph, etc. The following operations can be performed on stack. Push. This operation adds an item to the stack. Next operation is pop. It removes the item from the stack. Next is peek. It gives the value of top item without removing it. Next is empty. It checks if stack is empty or not. Next function is it's full. It checks whether the stack is full or not. Next question is, why do we use queues? Queues is an abstract data structure somewhat similar to the stack. In contrast to the stack, queue is open at both the end. One end is always used to insert the data and other is used to remove the data. Queue follows the first-in, first-out methodology, that is the data items sorted first will be accessed first. As queue follows the FIFO method, they are used when we need to work on the data items in an exact sequence of their arrival. Every operating system maintains queue of various processes. Priority queue and breadth first traverser of graph are some of the examples of queues. There are various operations that are performed on queues. First is enqueue. It is used to add items to the rear end of the queue. Next is dequeue. It removes the item from the front of the queue. Next is peek. It gives the value of the front item without removing it. Next function is empty. It checks whether the queue is full or not. Next is it's full. It is used to check whether the queue is full or not. Next question is, what is selection sort? Selection sort is a place sorting technique. It divides the data set into two sublists. First it's sorted, next is unsorted. Then it selects the minimum element from the unsorted sublist and places it into the sorted list. This iterates until all the elements from unsorted sublist are consumed into the sorted sublist. The next question is, what are the examples of greedy algorithms? So, there are some problems and to find their solution, we can use a greedy algorithm approach. Some of the greedy algorithms are traveling salesman problem, Prim's minimum spanning tree algorithm, Kruskal minimum spanning tree algorithm, Zyktra's minimum spanning tree algorithm, graph for map coloring, graph for vertex cover, knapsack problem and job scheduling problem. The next question is, can you give some examples of divide and conquer algorithm? The answer to this question is, there are some problems to find that solution, we use divide and conquer algorithm approach. Some of the algorithms are merge sort, quick sort, binary search, Strassen's matrix multiplication, and closest pair. The next question is, what is asymptotic analysis of an algorithm? Asymptotic analysis of an algorithm refers to defining of the mathematical or foundation framing of its runtime performance. Using the asymptotic analysis, we can very well conclude the best case, average case, and worst case scenario of an algorithm. Asymptotic analysis can provide three levels of mathematical binding of execution time of an algorithm. The best case is represented by omega of n notation. The worst case is represented by big O of n notation. And the average case is represented by theta of n notation. The last question of today's session is, why we need to do the algorithm analysis? The answer to this question is, a problem can be solved in more than one way. So many solution algorithms can be derived for the given problem. We can analyze available algorithms to find and implement the best suitable algorithm. An algorithm are generally analyzed according to the two factors. First is time and second is space. That is how much execution time and how much extra space required by the algorithm. It means that by deciding the time factor and the space factor required by the algorithm to calculate or to find out the solution, we can use or we can analyze the algorithm for the pieces. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India. And don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest video updates. If you like today's video, then like it, share it with your friends. Also, if you have any query, then please comment below. Remember one thing, sharing of knowledge is gaining of knowledge. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you.